I will be covering Lee Child. He's a British author. Lee Child actually is a pen name. It's a pen name for James Dover Grant. He was born in Coventry, England in 1954 and spent his early life in Birmingham, where he attended the King Edward School. He went on to study law at University of Sheffield, but he chose not to enter the legal profession. So instead, Child ventured into arts, working in television production, notably at the Granada Television in Manchester. So he was involved in the production of popular TV shows such as Brideshead, Revisited, and Prime Suspect. And it was this career which was going along, and then it ended up abruptly. So that's when his writing career began, in 1995, when the television career ended abruptly. So and we are all everyone needs to thank, like, his career ended abruptly, right? Because he's an amazing novelist, and I have personally enjoyed reading all of his novels. This turning point also was sort of the beginning of the most iconic character that we have known in modern thrillers and in modern literature as well, Jack Reacher. So his writing is very tight prose and very fast-paced action. And if I have to put one word from my side, I would say I liked reading his novels rather than watching the series. Usually I say sometimes the screen directors and the screenwriters and directors have done a pretty good job, whereas in this case they have done as much as they can, but his prose style of writing makes for such a good read that I would love rather than watch the series Jack Reacher. Each new novel edition, it comes with Jack Reacher exploring different facets of his own personality and something tied to the past, and also presents him with new challenges and the adversities that he has to face. So he's been going along with this contemporary time, I would say, from 1995 all the way till even now. The Jack Reacher novels are still going on, and I'll talk about one of the latest one as well after going through a few of the old ones where it all started. So The Killing Floor was the very first of Lee Child's creation, and this is where we get to observe what Jack Reacher is and his character developed from here. And Lee Child came up with Jack Reacher in 1997 with Killing Floor. And Jack Reacher is a person with no middle name. Reacher is a son of a Marine, childhood in 50 different places, then West Point, then military police in 100 different places, then the reductions in the workforce when the Cold War ended, leading directly to his sudden headfirst introduction to civilian life. A straightforward story, right? This is how Lee Child puts it when he introduces Jack Reacher. So, see, that is so tight that even I won't re-summarize or say anything else rather than just reading what Jack Reacher's description is. So, Reacher is a very formidable protagonist with a strong moral code and an affinity for justice and unparalleled skill set in combat skills and investigation. So all of these combined together make Reacher like a very formidable protagonist against any antagonist who wants to stand up against him or whoever he's investigating. The Killing Floor, the first chapter of the novel itself, and the first page itself, in fact, captures you and doesn't loosen its grip. I would again go and read. That's why I prefer reading Lee Child's novels rather than watching the series. So it says, "I was arrested in Eno's diner at 12 o'clock. I was eating eggs and drinking coffee, a late breakfast, not lunch. And then it goes on, I was in a booth at a window reading somebody's abandoned newspaper about the campaign for a president I didn't vote for last time and wasn't going to vote for this time. So that's like a few snippets of the first chapter itself and the first page. And you can imagine what goes on in the rest of the novel with the way Leech. It's amazing writing. And the scene setting itself for Killing Floor is Eno's Cafe in Margaret, where that first chapter starts. Margaret, Georgia, which is a fictional town, Reacher is arrested at this cafe on his soon after his arrival. He has got out from the bus, walked about 14 miles in the rain, and has reached his diner, and he's having something to eat, a breakfast, a kind of late breakfast and not lunch, as he says. And his decision to visit Margrave was influenced by a desire to trace a blues musician, right? And he quickly finds himself entrenched into this complex web of murder, conspiracy, and corruption. So upon his arrest, Reacher discovers that his brother, Joe Reacher, who was working for the Treasury Department, has been murdered. And that happened in Margrave. And he's the only stranger from out of town, which is why police end up arresting him at this cafe. And determined to uncover the truth and avenge his brother's death, Reacher delves into kind of that Margrave's underbelly, which uncovers a lot of massive counterfeiting operation. And from the first cover of the novel itself, you can see some counterfeit bills or a bill that is showed there. So the town, which is really a sleepy town and innocent at first glance, it harbors a dark secret. So Reacher finds himself not only local thugs, but there are also corrupt cops and powerful criminals. So with the help of Roscoe Conklin, local police officer, and Finlay, the chief of detectives, Reacher ends up unraveling a conspiracy that goes far beyond Margrave. And it's a vast counterfeiting scheme that is impacting a lot of other things that are being financed. So his military training and analytical mind becomes really crucial, and that helps him navigating through these violent encounters. And there has to be a lot of strategic planning that needs to happen in order to bring down this huge criminal network. And it's a fast-paced thriller, and Lee Child is known for it. So do go ahead and read this novel with a very intricate plot and a fast-paced narrative. The second one of Jack Reacher is Die Trying. So Die Trying is basically a story that kicks off in Chicago, where Reacher accidentally becomes involved in this kidnapping incident involving Kelly Holly Johnson, a beautiful and FBI agent and daughter of the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, a huge father being a big figure in the overall system. So the kidnappers, a militia group led by a charismatic criminal here, is very charismatic, and he's very ruthless, Bew Borkman. So you will love reading his description as well. And takes Reacher and Holly to their remote Montana compound. So the group itself plan involves using Holly as a leverage for a plot that threatens the very stability of US. So despite being a prisoner, Reacher's military training and with his analytical mind, he comes to comes to like always thrive in all these scenarios, right? And it's a key to surviving and understanding intentions of what is behind Bill Borkin's role of why he has kidnapped and what is his plan. So as the FBI and other government agencies try to mobilize and find Holly and Richard, the narrative delves into the themes of patriotism and the lengths to which individuals go for their beliefs, the belief system that they have, and overall comes to the theme of survival. And the remote Montana setting, it kind of provides a stark setting where it emphasizes isolation and danger with this action-packed story. So Richard's physical prowess, of course, he's killed in combat, are on full display as he seeks to protect Holly and kind of lay some obstacles to the militia's plans. So it is a gripping combat scenes and good strategic maneuvers and a complex motivation that you will be surprised to find out that is driving Borkin and his followers. So Reacher gets down to the bottom of all of this, and it's a dynamic between Reacher and Holly also that you get to see that it's a hint of a romance, there is suspense, action, all of this mixed together. And if I'm not mistaken, Lee Child, I think, currently resides in Montana, maybe as well, but I think this is a very good setting, Montana setting as well for his second home. Tripwire is the third in the Jack Reacher series. So it begins with Reacher living like a very low-key life in Key West. So he's always presented with new scenarios, and he has to tackle them with his own wit and strategic maneuvers and use his combat skills to his advantage. So there is a new challenge every time that he's facing in all of these novel series. And it's an in-depth dissection of the motives and the purpose. So in this case, he's found in Key West, Florida, right? And he's digging swimming pools by hand and working as a bouncer to stay under the radar, essentially. And his tranquil existence is disrupted. There is a private investigator named Costello who is looking at him and looking for Jack Reacher and trying to investigate around Jack Reacher, but he's found murdered. So driven by his own need to find out why he was being sought by Costello, Reacher embarks on this journey, and that leads him to New York City. And in New York City, he reunites with Jody Garber, and she's the daughter of his former commanding officer, the CEO, General Garber. And Jody is now a lawyer. And through Jody, Reacher learns that General Garber was investigating the mysterious disappearance of a young Vietnam war veteran, like an MIA, Victor Hobby, before the CEO was killed. And Reacher's quest in trying to find out what was behind Hobby's disappearance and Costello's murder, so he has to solve both of these. It involves a very complex narrative that involves a ruthless businessman, Chester Stone, whose enterprises don't seem what they really are meant to stand for. And Reacher kind of uncovers like it's a horrifying business exploiting the families of the veterans and the MIAs, the missing in actions, kind of for war veterans, right? So Reacher needs to pursue like sort of this disfigured war veteran turned criminal mastermind, and that sort of tests his limits and his way of how he wants to resolve. So it dives deep into this into this horrified business that has been made of exploiting the families. So that's where Reacher is at his best in this third novel, Friday. And the fourth one, I really jump and across many Jack Reacher series, and I jump into the recent one. And the recent one is called The Sentinel. and you'll see Lee Child and Andrew Child are writing together. So they are the co-authors. So Lee Child passed over the baton to his younger brother, and his name is Andrew Child, and they came together with this novel Sentinel. The novel is a pivotal entry for Andrew Child, and it brings in a new theme and a new character that has grown, really, really grown. And it really shows Jack Reacher in this new role where he has kind of progressed through solving all of these crimes the whole way, but now he's stepping into something new. So Reacher finds himself in this nondescript town where chances lead him to an attempted kidnapping. So the Reacher in his saves the potential victim with his natural instincts that come into play, and Rusty Rutherford, who is an average IT manager, but has recently been a scapegoat for a catastrophic cyber attack on the town's municipal systems. So this cyber attack has left the town's infrastructure on the brink of collapse. So it kind of highlights the vulnerabilities in America's cybersecurity. So it captures on that theme. So that's where Jack Reacher has grown, fighting sort of after the Cold War and now down to this modern era of cybersecurity. So it becomes clear that Rutherford is not just an innocent bystander, but he holds the key to understanding and stopping what is much larger of a scheme. And it has nationwide implications. So the novel expertly weaves all these technological vulnerabilities, the espionage, and the unseen warfare that exists in the digital age. So it is set up against the sophisticated threats that Reacher has not faced before. So that brings a very good introduction of Andrew Child, and I love to read him as well. And they are co-authoring this particular novel. So it shows Reacher's character, kind of his ability to adapt, and there is a need for humans to adapt to all these ongoing changes that are happening. And there is also an evolving threat, nature of threats that are increasing in this world. And we are more and more reliant on technology. And this dives into data privacy, cyber terrorism, and the potential of technology being weaponized overall. So it's a nice read and a very good read in the contemporary times, I would say.